Hey guys, good morning or good afternoon, wherever you are. So finally, the cat is outside the box. So this is Celestron Edge HD 14. I like seeing things rather than just taking pictures, so I would like to have something where I can see. So this one is actually a replacement of 8SE for me. I wanted to put a Hyperstar on this one and take good pictures. That was the plan, and it turned into Rasa, and you know, I'm still using Rasa. And if you can see in the back, I'm still working on it. I put a 0.7 reducer on this, just to get a, otherwise it's F11, it's very difficult to take pictures with F11, so I put a 0.7 reducer. It's still really close to the sky, and I put a couple of adapters, and I put an off-axis girder. It's not really focusing, so this is always a problem, so I got to figure out what's going on with off-axis girder. If it is off-axis girder for this long focal length, I think this will be really good. So I'm figuring out what's going on here. If this doesn't work, I might go to the Celestron off-axis girder, because I knew like that was working. I tried to put this one because the ZW one is the ZW off-axis girder is smaller, so I'm trying to use that for now. If you see the image training, there is a IR UV filter right here. I just wanted to put one shot color here, and without IR UV, I don't think one shot color pictures come good for me, at least. So that's why I put that on the image train. But if you can see here, there is a filter slider like the one that I was using on my Rasa. This is from Starizone. I put a couple of adapters there to make it work. And then this one I wanted to put like a H-alpha filter in it if I'm taking a one shot color. So I'll try, it's not permanent image train yet. So I didn't even do cable management or anything. I'm also using the Celestron focuser. This is pretty good. It has some issues with 14 because the housing is too tight, and you got to make it a little loose when you're installing it. I'll go over the details of this focuser later. But once if you make it like one of the screws loose, then it'll start moving. This is the best upgrade Celestron had ever done. I think people forget, actually there used to be a knob that you can turn to focus. This will become probably standard on most of the Celestron telescopes. This is a precise focus. You can actually take this off and put a visual eyepiece in it. You know exactly which number to go to. You put this back and you know, press that number. It goes exactly for this camera. Awesome features inside. Once you calibrate this one, it's doing a pretty good job. I really like the focuser. It's a pretty good focuser. I think pretty good upgrade. I'll do the review of this telescope later. Complete review. I'm fairly new for this telescope. As you can see, I put it on CGXL mount. It's C14. I used to think C14s are really big. But once I dealt with Rasa 11, C14 seems to be the normal telescope. It feels like 8SE, I'm kidding, but it's still heavy, but it's not that heavy as it was. So it's pretty neat. Actually, it does balance well. It has a little back heavy right now, but I'm going to fix that back heavy thing. I just changed my image train, so just now. So I just need to move the telescope front. Otherwise, this balance is good, and this balance is pretty good as well. It's pretty neat actually. It balances everything very, very well. Let me try that. I wanted to see if I can guide this properly and take some good picture of it using the one shot color. See how it turns out to be. I'll show you my workflow.